Okay. Good morning. Good morning, Windsor Assembly Plan. Good morning and welcome to all our visitors. Thanks for joining us here today on a very special occasion. My name is Michael Breda, Plant Manager of Windsor Assembly Plant. The videos you just saw show how far this plant has come in such a relatively short amount of time. Within the last year, major construction, relaunch of the RT, Dodge Caravan, and now the launch of the Pacifica. A year of change and excitement for all of us here at the plant. As you saw in the video, the official job one was on February 29th, 2016. But here we're here today with some very special guests to publicly recognize this milestone. The Pacifica is an all-new Canadian-built vehicle, one which is incredibly important not just to Fiat Chrysler automobiles, but also to the 6,000 employees here who build them for the world right here in Windsor, Ontario. Windsor Proud is a statement that adorns one of the new banners around the exterior of the plant. Windsor is the city where I personally was born, raised, studied, and grew up in the area, the East End, in the shadows of Chrysler Assembly Plants. So I am both proud and humbled to be leading the Windsor Assembly Plant family through this very important time in our history. I'm delighted that Sergio Marchionne, CEO of Fiat Chrysler Automobiles, members of the FCA senior management team, as well as Jerry Diaz, national president of Unifor, and Dino Kyoto, president of Unifor Local 444, to the Windsor Assembly Plant to join us here today. So thank you for your time. In addition, there is a new retiree who used to walk many kilometers and marathons in this place through his career, who set the foundation for world-class manufacturing when we launched the original 2007 Dodge Caravan in Chrysler Town and Country. So I'd also like to welcome Marcel Bro back to Windsor Assembly Plant. We're glad you can join us, Marcel. Overall, the launch process for the all-new Pacifica is on schedule. Thanks in no small part to the work and dedication of all the employees here at Windsor Assembly Plant. Reflecting back to January at the Detroit Auto Show, it's very difficult to convey how anxious we were for the unveiling of the new Pacifica for the global reveal. It was the coming out party for the brand new baby, our brand new baby, on the world stage. And as we watched the Pacifica make its debut, we all breathed a very big sigh of relief when it was welcomed with enthusiasm by global media, and shortly thereafter from the general public. Now today, as you can see behind me, 2017 Pacificas are rolling down the assembly line here at Windsor, and I can tell you that our newly expanded Canadian workforce is both delighted and motivated to deliver the best product possible for our customers. A few months ago, in December of 2015, the local Unifor team, along with plant staff, delivered 8 minivans full of toys to support the local community toy event. At that event, I was asked by the media about the new minivan, and of course, at the time, I said nothing about the product because we were under sweet secrecy at the time, but I summed it up in one short statement. All I said was, you're gonna love it. That's all I said. And surprisingly enough, it made it to print, which is a good thing because that's exactly what's happened. It's extremely rewarding for all of us to already be receiving positive news from first vehicle drives of the vehicle about the new Pacifica. And on top of that, even awarded one of the 10 best interiors for this model so far. Now, recognition like that from outside these walls helps validate for us here at the plant that our hard work and efforts to make the Pacifica the best minivan on the planet have not gone unnoticed. So again, to each and every one of our employees here, I say thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for your efforts thus far. This minivan, this Pacifica, is hands down the best vehicle we've ever built here at Windsor Assembly Plant in our nearly 90 year of existence. In my 22 years with the company, personally, I've never seen so much attention to detail, to quality, testing, research and development, performance, and customer focus groups early on to make sure that we get all aspects of the product right the first time. Sergio, to you, I'd like to extend a special thank you for your commitment to this plant and for your confidence in our workforce's ability. So thank you for delivering us this wonderful product. We may be a facility with as much history as the company itself, but thanks to world-class manufacturing processes you introduced to FCA and the significant investments made into the retooling upgrades here at Windsor, we are now ready to build a world-class and award-winning vehicle to exceed the expectation of our customers worldwide. We are blessed and thankful to be the home of the 2017 Chrysler Pacifica. Every Pacifica is produced using the hands, heads, and hearts of our employees. What motivates us here at Windsor is that every hour of every day, we know we're not just building vehicles, but more importantly, we're building memories for our future customers. So with that, I'd like to take this time to invite Mr. Sergio Marchionne up to say a few words. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael, and good afternoon to all of you. I am delighted to be back here in Windsor and to join you today in the celebration of the production launch of the 2017 Chrysler Pacifica. I'm not sure if any of you here were around in 1983 when the Windsor Assembly Plant gave birth to the world's first minivan ever, the exact same one that is on display across the aisle. But that vehicle represented an entirely new concept, and it was a historic game changer when it comes to family transportation. Since that day, FCA has built 14.3 million minivans, with a record 10 million of those rolling off the lines here in Windsor. You have undoubtedly earned the right to be proud of the leading role that you've played in making us the undisputed leader in minivans, which is a tradition that we intend to fully maintain with the new Pacifica that we're launching today. Incidentally, 7 out of every 10 minivans sold in Canada last year, which is an incredible number, 7 out of every 10 minivans sold in Canada came from this plant. And I can tell you that without that, we would have not been able to be the number one automaker in this country in 2015. So up to now, at least until the end of April, we're still the Canadian sales leader. And with your help, we intend to keep it for the remainder of 2016 and hopefully forever. We have a great confidence in that the new Pacifica is going to once again set the standard in a segment that we have led now for nearly 3 decades. It is a reflection of all things that we've learned over the course of 33 years in making this car. It's a forthright expression of our technical know-how with advancements such as the segment's first electrified hybrid model. In addition, the thoughtful interior design, as Michael mentioned, has already been honored with a spot on the world's list of top 10 interiors. But at the end of the day, it is the work that all of you do on the line and in your stations that will determine whether this new product satisfies customers and extends our success. This plant is not only a crucial part of FCA's commercial and industrial plans, it is also a vital part of the city. We are the only automaker that is left operating an assembly plant in this town, right here in the heart of Windsor, which is why the plant has often been referred to as having the pulse of the city. And I promise you that we'll do our best to keep this pulse continuing to beat strong. But all of you who work here are really the heart and soul of our Windsor operations. What you do here is important to your community, to your neighbors, to their families. And this minivan means a great deal to FCA. It is, of course, an important contributor to building our customer base, but it's also an enduring symbol how we can beat bigger competitors when we can out-innovate them by working together at every level, recognizing that we have a vital stake in each other's success. I want to express my deep appreciation for the way in which all of you have embraced world-class manufacturing, which is deep down a way of just committing to the elimination of waste And as Michael said, it depends on the hearts and the heads and the hands of the people that work here in our shops. I want to thank Unifor for their support during the implementation of WCM and the preparation for the launch of the Pacifica, and I look forward to working with Jerry and his team to craft a new agreement this year that will allow for a long-term mutually beneficial success. Windsor Assembly has established a high benchmark for all of our North American operations by becoming the first plant in the region to achieve silver status. And I want to congratulate you for earning this result. It is a huge recognition of the work that you've done in the past and for all the progress that you've made. It speaks to the very spirit that lives here, to the culture and to the respect and continuous improvement that you have nourished every day. But above all, it is a testament to the kind of people you are. People who want to get involved, people who want to take responsibility and leave their mark. People who make things happen, ultimately people who care about the future. I know that you set your sights even higher, and I believe this is truly your chance to show the world what you're truly capable of. The Pacifica will not just redefine the minivan market, it's going to redefine the role and the future of this plant also. I'd like to consider today's event as a celebration of Pacifica production as well as day one of a new ambitious vision for this assembly plant. Today is the right moment to ask ourselves what next, what we want this plant to become 2 years from now. My vision is clear, and it's based on what you've already demonstrated so far. Your dedication, your passion, and your openness to new ideas in order to put out the highest quality product possible. What you went through and what you were able to do to prepare to build this new minivan, especially to quickly reestablish the high quality production levels after a 3-month shutdown, is another example of the spirit that I'm talking about. And I believe that this positive attitude will enable you to achieve 2 additional significant goals that will keep the benchmark that you already set very high. The first target is for Windsor to achieve gold status in 2017 and to be recognized as one of the best manufacturing facilities in the world. But secondly, and equally important, is our vision for this facility's quality ranking to score in the top 25% according to J.D. Power. If you're able to achieve these goals, and I trust and I firmly believe that you will simply prove to the world what you're made of and that you will go a long way towards controlling your own destiny and the ultimate destiny of this plant. In closing, I want to share with you a few observations about family ties. Michael introduced me to his father and to his father-in-law, some of whom have worked here before he showed up. So the importance of family is part of the very fabric of this plant. In addition to building the ultimate family-friendly vehicle, you've also adopted a family of one as your plant model. And I've seen, I was very impressed by some of your children's artwork that demonstrates they have been tapping into their creative talent and their vivid imaginations to depict what the minivan really means to them. I regard all this as family. The bond that links us is not one of blood, it is a bond that has been created by mutual respect, by joy in each other's well-being, and by a shared desire to leave a positive legacy for those who come after us. At the center of WCM is a fundamental recognition of who you are and the importance of what you do. You play an indispensable part in shaping the destiny of this house and of this community, because you don't just make cars, you make a difference. The Pacifica needs to be a vehicle that we can all be proud of, and I have every confidence in all of you, the men and women of Windsor Assembly, to continue the tradition of excellence that you've already established. I've seen what you can do, and it reinforces my faith in our collective future. I want to thank you for what you do, but especially I want to thank you for who you are. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you, Sergio. The plant is committed to continue to make you proud. Okay, so thank you for those kind words. And now It's with good pleasure to introduce Jerry Diaz, president of Unifor.
Well, good afternoon, Windsor. I can't hear you. Come on, let's go. It's a celebration. All right. Since I have the podium, I can say what I want, right? So right off the bat, I don't like the seating configuration at all today. So all the bosses, I want you to get out of the chair and get to the back of the room, and I want all the workers, our members, to come to the front of the room. No, I'm only kidding, for Christ's sakes. Reed, you invested $2 billion, you can sit anywhere you want. I'm kidding, for crying out loud. Sit down. Well, good afternoon, and what a day it is today. What a celebration today, and think about it, we have come a long way. So I want to start my remarks by thanking Sergio, by thanking Reed. I want to thank the entire Fiat Chrysler team for such confidence, such faith they've showed in all of us, and thank you so much for this incredible investment, my friend. So this investment, it's not only about us, it's not only about our jobs, it's not only about our futures, it's really about the futures of the kids. Look at the kids that are here today. So it's about our entire families, and it really is about our entire community. I remember in 1983 when the first minivan rolled off the line. I remember what the analysts said. They said, oh, that is one ugly vehicle. Nobody's going to buy them. Well, here we are 33 years later, 10 million minivans later, and guess who's buying them? Everybody's buying them. 10 million minivans. Congratulations. And you know why? Because we build these Pacificas with pride, union pride. So today, all eyes are on Windsor, because we have a plan. We have a strategy. We have a strategy how to create jobs. We have a strategy about how to put people to work. And I'm going to use this opportunity. And I'm going to use this opportunity to say to the federal and the provincial politicians who are not here, and they're not here because they didn't invest in this community. They didn't invest in our jobs. So I'm going to use this opportunity to say that the successful auto industries around the world need government understanding, need government support. So I'm saying to Justin Trudeau and the new government in Ottawa, it's time for the government to understand the roles and the respect that must be given to the auto players because of the responsibilities and the pivotal role that we play in our communities. We've been through 10 years, and we've survived it. So now this is the government's opportunity to make sure the next 10 years are about incredible leadership, and it's about incredible growth. 2016 is going to be the most pivotal year in the history of our industry. So I'm saying, partner with Windsor, partner with Brampton. Partner with Fiat Chrysler, partner with Unifor, because when you partner with us, then it's a winning partnership for all of us. And I want to talk to Windsor, because in Windsor we have 50 auto parts plants, 12,000 direct auto jobs, 57,000 spin-off jobs, $250 million a year in income and property taxes. And you know what we do with our $250 million? We donate to the United Way. We build women's shelters. We build roads. We build hospitals. We build the community. So today, I say to the rest of Canada, and I say to all the citizens, on Sunday is Mother's Day. So don't go buy mom a massage or some chocolates or some clothes. No, no. Go to your Fiat Chrysler dealership and buy her a plug-in electric Pacifica. And I want to end my remarks And I say this sincerely, brothers and sisters. Fiat Chrysler made the commitment. They made the investment. Always remember, not 1 cent of profit, not one Pacifica would roll off the line if it wasn't for your brains, your sweat, and your determination. So today is your day. Congratulations, you've earned it. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Jerry. I know it means a lot on your busy schedule to be here today for the local union membership, so thank you for those kind remarks. And sales should spike this coming Monday, I would think, this coming Monday, so we're looking forward to that. I'd now like to introduce somebody, a man of few words. Many of you already know him. I'd like to introduce Dino Kyoto to the podium.
So first off, I just want to start by saying thank you to Fiat Chrysler for inviting me here today to say a few words. I think it's important that we celebrate today and we make sure we recognize all the people that made this happen. We're eligible to come to the table and talk about what we need to do to make things better right here in Windsor, Ontario. So first and foremost, I want to recognize all the employees of the Windsor Assembly Plant for your hard work, your dedication, your persistence, your passions, and your patience. Now, why I get into that is because we started off in 2012 not really being sure with regards to where we are going, getting to a bronze level in world-class manufacturing. Today, we are silver. We are one of the best at what we do, and it's because of your commitment. So thank you to the workers at the Windsor Assembly Plant for your dedication in that. I also want to thank TPTs, because without them, we couldn't get the days off that we need. And at the same time, they provide some great service with regards to making sure that van is built right. I also want to thank the inside committee, the plant committee, the representatives, the specialists, because they all play a role in making sure that we're doing what we need to do to build this vehicle properly. But the family is bigger than that. The family includes the OC&E group from 1498 that does a great job behind the scenes, making sure that they're connected, getting the proper VINs, making sure that we have all the logistics taken care of. So thank you to them. I also want to talk about the ONA Local 8 nurses that do a wonderful job with regards to making sure that we're healthy when we're not feeling well, going to first aid, getting taken care of. We also got to talk about Local 195. You talk about security doing a magnificent job, first responders. If somebody were to have an issue, a health concern, and they got a report, they're one of the best in the industry across the industry. And also Team Industrial, who keep this place clean regularly on a regular basis. We are truly, like Mark Chioni said earlier, a family of one. Congratulations to every one of you. By extension of that, and I don't want to keep us in silos because I think it's important to really recognize a group that spends a lot of hours in putting a lot of stuff together. They get direction, they have to implement processes, and that's the management team. Because the reality is, we can't do it alone. And any one of those locals that I just talked about won't be able to do it alone. So to the management team, for your insight, dedication, determination, and drive, thank you for all your hard work, because without each other, we can't survive. I want to take a quick moment for special recognition now. Because I know Sergio Marchionne's got a busy schedule. It's hard to get a phone call back from him. But at the end of the day, I'm sure we'll have an opportunity to speak. Because he told me that he was the individual, the locomotive, that would decide where investment would go. And the reality was, he said, if you guys stay on the path, you guys work in world-class manufacturing, and you guys have a buy-in with regards to where we go, we would look at the needs of the Windsor Assembly Plant. And in saying that, Sergio, thank you for going it alone. Thank you for doing this without the politicians, because we'd probably be in a worse position anyway. So thank you very much for the $2.6 billion investment at the Windsor Assembly Plant. Now, I'm sure a lot of people probably want to hear something about bargaining, but this isn't the day to talk about negotiations. I'm going to save some of those comments for later because I'm sure me and Serge will have an opportunity to have these discussions and figure out how we do this going forward. But we've always had a great relationship with Chrysler, Fiat Chrysler, and I'm sure even after bargaining, we'll have a great relationship and do what's necessary to make sure that we stay on the straight and narrow and get to where we need to be, especially in protecting Windsor and the families of Windsor Assembly Plant employees. So I want to talk a little bit about vision. Because the reality is, without the Windsor Assembly Plant in Windsor, Ontario, what would we really be? And the reason why I raise that is it's frustrating. We've talked about there's no provincial monies, there's no federal monies, but we haven't heard anything from a municipal level either. Sure, we've heard the mayor come out and talk about, you know, call center jobs at minimum wage and doing a press release with reference to that. We've heard the mayor come out and talk about, hey, the airport's getting 50 jobs and we got to be proud about what we've accomplished for my friend Eddie. But the reality is, we're here today working collaboratively, really making a difference in this community. Over 1,200 new jobs hired in the Windsor Assembly Plant. That's a total of 5,800 employees, brothers and sisters. What would this city look like? And I know Jerry already touched on with regards to the taxes, but think about it, $1.2 million in the United Way. Over $100,000 in gate collections that were done with regards to the toy drive you heard about earlier. Also with Razor Eater, with the Windsor Star, the food banks. What would happen if the Windsor Assembly Plant wasn't here? And a man like Sergio Marchionne wasn't able to say, we're doing it alone. And that's some of the challenges that we're going to be faced with in the future. What would happen to the Tim Hortons, of course? Because they'd have to basically shut down some of their facilities because we wouldn't be drinking as much coffee, that's for sure. But the corner stores, doctors, dentists, nurses, teachers, there would be a big gaping hole in the city of Windsor. And first and foremost, I would think that the mayor of this community would be saying, Windsor Assembly Plant, thanks for all that you do. Fiat Chrysler, thanks for your investment. And we're still waiting to hear what they have to say. That's shameful. I just want to preface something that's happening. It's pretty amazing. It's come in the media over the last couple of days. It's with regards to talking about what we can do with Google. Innovation, moving forward. How the new future of minivans is going to look. That's amazing when you really think about thinking that much further ahead. But the reality is we have politicians that don't think that far ahead. So we are working on a policy and solutions forum actually next week. So this is a great segue to be able to talk about that. Where we bring the Chamber of Commerce and work collaboratively with the labor groups. Where we take the academics from the University of Windsor through Dr. Alan Wildeman and St. Clair College through Patty France. And we're talking to politicians at the provincial level saying you need to get directly involved. Because with agreements like the free trade agreement, the TPP, we're in trouble. And if there isn't a mechanism for companies to be able to get investment, we're in bigger trouble in the future. So we're not only a family of one, we are a combined family that builds vehicle right the first time. And I appreciate all your hard work and dedication, because it really is us collaboratively doing what's in the best interest of not only Windsorites, but Ontario and Canada. So we build the car right, but it's not only the cars that we build, it's the memories we create. And I know there's a big placard outside that speaks to that, but I bring it up because it's not everything you do inside the plant that counts. It's everything you do in touch within this community. And I say thank you very much to each and every one of you, to Sergio Marchionne, your team. It's been a great trek, and I look forward to the future. So thank you very much.
Jerry and I were sitting over here, and all of a sudden I got the scare of my life. I saw Ken Lorenza. No, I'm serious. Show up from the back alley, and I thought there was going to be this secret bargaining weapon that Unifor will use in the 2016 labor negotiations. You know, it's enough to scare most of us to think that Ken will come back and give us his English rendition of anything he's ever heard. So I'll pass it to you.
You know, I listened to Dino talk about vision. There he is. I listened to Dino talk about vision. And I've been around this Chrysler family a long, long time. And I've been in a lot of bargaining with old Chrysler. And I'll tell you, I remember the days when there was two minivan plants, one in St. Louis and one here. And I'm telling you right now, we wouldn't be here today for the celebration if it wasn't for the strength, the conviction, the courage of Ken Lewenza. So on behalf of us all here, Ken, thank you very much, brother.
Thank you, Jerry.
I, of course, didn't expect this because I'm in the secondary leadership position in support of our existing leadership, but you can't help to stand up and be humbled in recognition of what we have collectively been through in the last decade. I will someday write a book about the future of this plant. Someday, I'll write a book about the meeting that Marchione and I had in a restaurant in Toronto, where he said to me, Ken, this is what needs to be done for Chrysler Corporation to survive. Are you on board or not? And at that particular time, let's not kid anybody, I never had a lot of power. I said, Sergio, whatever we need to do to create jobs, to sustain the Canadian economy, to build opportunity for the future, the CAW and now Unifor will be there. And I'll tell you, it was a tough conversation. But I want to say, as Jerry and Dino's already said, this is a humble time. It's a time of reflection. It's a time of recognizing that if you don't think about the past and understand the past, then you can't move to the future. We can never have a past of instability, never have a past of bankruptcy, never have a past of insecurity. Collectively, we can build and continue to build something great here. And something great is providing decent jobs, decent opportunities, not just for ourselves, but for future generations. Our excitement is not about me, this short little fat guy. My excitement's about the next generation having the same opportunities as me. My excitement is about your kids and children having the same opportunities as their parents. And at the end of the day, this Pacifica will do it. The same with the minivan. And I ask everybody to get out there and be a salesperson for the minivan. When you see a driver of a minivan, say thank you, and all of you, thank you.
Thank you, Ken, Dino, and Jerry. It's a good thing we got the extra strong speaker system, right, for these guys. So that was worth the upgrade. So good job, guys. So with that, the family of one model, which you've heard many times from each of our presenters, you know, supporting our families, our community as our family, being proud of what we build and working as a team. That's what our philosophy is here at Windsor. One example of that is the collective and concerted efforts of the workforce to keep this vehicle completely under wraps until its global debut. In a world full of cell phones and pictures and spy shots, there was not one single leak of this vehicle that we started producing in June of 2015 until the debut in January 2016. So congratulations to everybody. That just shows the spirit of the team here, that you care about your future. And we have to protect our future. So a commitment and a sense of family continues here today. So now with the Pacifica behind me on the production line, and now more importantly, soon to be in the hands of our dealers and our future customers and families, our workforce is finally able to experience for themselves and discuss what this all new vehicle means to them. So we decided to ask a few of our employees what features of the all new Pacifica stood out the most to them, and why they are so proud to be part of making them. So we'll show you a short video.
My favorite feature of the car is the panoramic sunroof. So all of that beautiful sunlight's allowed to come in. It really opens up the spaciousness of the cabin itself, which is already pretty exciting.
Storage is the biggest deal for me, and we have plenty of storage.
Well, having three daughters and doing many long road trips, I like the fold-down monitors on the back of the screen.
The panoramic sunroof.
My favorite feature, because I have a young child, I love the kick wave. That's my favorite feature, opening up with just the wave of my foot on the lift gate.
My favorite feature, I like the panoramic sunroof.
My favorite part of the Pacifica, I think, is the part where you put your foot underneath and it opens the sliding door.
I have two. One is the hands-free opening of the doors. You just open with your foot, and the DVD players that are built into the seats.
It solely has to do with the level of engagement of the hourly and salary at the frontline level. Without their passion, the product would fail. So their passion and their involvement and their willingness to never stop until success is the key to the product we build today and the product that's going to keep us around here for a long time.
People that I work with, they're very cognizant of their work environment. They don't miss a thing. If they notice a part that's missing, they're on it right away. They let me know. I put that part in, and I feel proud that at the, you know, once the doors leave our area, that they're 100%.
It's been very rewarding, just actually as we're building more cars, just seeing the success rate as the build goes up, seeing all the changes that you've implemented in the car being completed.
We make sure that the vehicle is perfect when it leaves.
People in our group are pretty prideful because we got in on the ground floor and we had involvement all the way through every step of design. We got to argue with the engineers, we got to have a lot of input in how this vehicle was made.
It's a long history of pride. I've been here 32 years, obviously. The original home of the minivan, and we want to continue that pride.
For our customers, we want to make sure that they get the best possible product. When you hear this family of one, what does it mean? For me, the family of one means, even though we're many departments, final, trim, chassis, we all combine together as one. Just as a family, you have the mom, you have the dad, you have the children. Each one contributes to the household in some form or another.
The atmosphere here is very family-like. So the family of one is that this, the whole family working towards one direction, one goal, is to make this place the best place it can be.
The family of one means that everybody's involved. What affects them is affecting me. So what is affecting them on their jobs affects what I'm doing to them, for them.
When you have somebody that cares, that's family in a sense. So family of one it's a big place. We all wonder how the other one's doing. We don't know everybody in this place, but the ones I know of, I care for.
It's not about positions, it's not about power, it's not about what you do. We're all here to be successful and meet the customer's expectation by building the best van possible.
We have a very close-knit work family with our coworkers, our leadership, a lot of the people on the line, the employees that we work with. We've become a very close family spending all this time together.
From day one being here, I was treated like family. I was treated like everybody accepted me, and I'm very happy to be here, like I said.
Family of One to me represents the company, the union, and the brothers and sisters on the floor working together to make a quality vehicle for our customers.
Sergio was discussing with us earlier, the more and more you see videos of the Pacifica going down the road, the more striking you see the vehicle is. It's a beautiful vehicle. Again, we're very grateful to be building it. And you can tell from the video that a few of our employees are going to be anxious to drive one. So fantastic. So on behalf of all of our employees here at Windsor, I want to thank Mr. Marchione, FCA's senior management team that is here today, Jerry and Dino as well, for being an active and special part of this event. So thank you for your time today. And we know that the pride of the workforce will shine through in the quality of this vehicle for our customers. And we're looking forward to many, many awards in the very near future with it. So Very, very good. So at this time, this concludes today's special event. So again, I appreciate everybody's participation today. What we're gonna do is have a hold back for the media for a few moments here on the stage to take a few photos. So again, thank you to all the employees here at Windsor. Thank you, Sergio, Jerry, Dino. Thank you to the FCA management team. Great job, everybody. Great job.